Of a sixpenny ticket, British cinema goers could get a front row seat to some of the most dramatic moments of the 20th century. In September 1938, tensions between Nazi Germany and Czechoslovakia were threatening to drag the whole of Europe into full-scale war. In a bid to defuse the situation, the British Prime Minister Neville Chamberlain travelled to Munich to meet with Hitler.
Let no man say that too high a price has been paid for the peace of the world until he has searched his own soul and found himself willing to risk war and the lives of those nearest and dearest to him.
Chamberlain made a deal with Hitler. To secure peace, he acceded to German occupation of the Czech Sudetenland.
And the Prime Minister comes home, home to an empire filled with joy and relief, home to a welcome that he will never forget.
Arriving back at a rain-soaked British airport, he made a speech that would go down in history.
This morning, I had another talk with the German Chancellor, Herr Hitler. And here is the paper which bears his name upon it as well as mine.
These images of Neville Chamberlain waving his piece of white paper have become so iconic. But if we go back and give the context to this piece, we see something completely different. Pathé, in many respects, reflects the mood of the country.
Let the people themselves speak what is in their hearts.
When this story was first shown in the cinemas, people were cheering Neville Chamberlain. But a week afterwards, when Chamberlain came on the screen, there was just complete silence.